I knew you were going to be the first question. So I want our identity to play extremely hard. I'm not going to tell you that we're going to be a basketball team that don't make mistakes. I'm not going to tell you that we're a basketball team that we're going to win every game right away. But, I think this fan base, I think they deserve a team that if you're going to pay money to come watch us play, and you're going to support us like the support that we have here, they want to see a great product. Our guys are going to dive on the floor, they're going to take charges, they're going to play so hard. And that's what our identity should be. When you look around NC State, it's great facilities. You've got everything that's out there. It's a tremendous academic university. You've got great leadership. It's nothing, there's no negatives about this place. So we should be able to put a product on the floor and play so hard and be proud to represent this university.
Coach, Jonathan Alexander, News and Observer. You started a little behind on recruiting, being the journey coach. How do you plan to approach recruiting going forward as a new coach?
I think you said you started behind on recruiting a little bit.
Being that you just got hired.
Well, I think the most important thing is I only recruit my team. These guys are the most important guys. I will concentrate on these guys right now, obviously making sure that they finish off strong academically. Secondly, we get the opportunity to get to the basketball court. We want to start getting those guys in shape. I want to make sure that everybody's prepared for what we have to offer as a basketball program. Obviously, I'm taking a different approach than a lot of coaches. When you go out recruiting late, a lot of times it's like shopping on December 24th. You got to take whatever's left out of there. And for me, I want to make sure that we get the right people to fit into the mission statement.
Hey Coach, Jeff Brown at WRMTV. Welcome. And how do you make sure when you do recruit players and they come here that you squeeze every ounce of potential and talent from those players? Player development is something that we talked about as a strength of yours.
Yeah, I've always I've got a couple of things that that's made me the coach that I am. I've always been able to develop guys. And, when I was in Hargrave Military Academy, a lot of people think Hargrave is in high school, but it's an elite prep school where, we were averaging 10 or 11 Division I guys per year. A lot of those guys went on to become pros. The way we were able to help those guys achieve their goals were skill development. I told these guys in a meeting yesterday, what I do different than most head coaches is that I'm the one that's involved with the individual workouts. I don't pass it along to the assistant coaches. Now, understanding that I have some obligation as a head coach where we have to be speaking or recruiting at times, but I'm going to develop these guys, and you're going to see the difference in those guys after the summer, because that's the way you have to improve. When you're a freshman, you've got to become a better sophomore. As a sophomore, you've got to become a better junior. I don't like guys that don't get better.
Let's go to Corey and then Rob.
Coach, Corey Smith, UNC Journal. You mentioned the fan base, obviously you kind of brought that up, saying that it's something that you love, something that you enjoyed. What aspect of the fan base would you say kind of drew you to it, and what made you want to mention it?
Well, when you read the media, everybody's so tough on our fan base. And I ask the question, why? Don't you want a fan base that want to win? Don't you want a fan base that want to have some bragging rights? I love the opportunity. I would rather have a fan base that's behind you and very, maybe a little critical when things go on, instead of nobody coming to the games at all. And for me, I love my fans. And it's up to me as a coach to make sure that we put a great product on the floor for those fans.
Rob McGlynn with Pat Pride. Coach, what type of timetable do you have in terms of settling in Raleigh, hiring assistants and such?
Well, man, that's the best question I've heard so far. I'm in Raleigh now. The great thing about me taking this job is, my home in Wilmington is only an hour and 45 minutes, but, I'm here now, and I'm going to start recruiting. I'm going to start putting together a very unique staff. Number one, probably next week. And when I'm looking for a staff, I'm looking for a staff that, number one, that can get along with those guys. Every step of the way, everywhere that I've been, it's all about family. My wife, George, I'll tell you, our guys at Hargrave and UNCW, they spend more time in our house than we do sometimes. And that's important to me because, you know, finding a staff that gets along, that has no egos, everybody's on one accord, and that's a good thing for me, and that's what we're going to do. We'll put together a really great staff that can recruit. Obviously, recruiting is the a major deal in college basketball, and it's a lifeline of your program, and certainly that's what we want to do. But I'm looking forward to starting it next week.
Take a question over here, and then we'll go to the back.
Coach Anderson, with the technician, there's obviously with this program here a lot of talk about the other two local schools in the area, Duke and North Carolina, and you know, kind of going head to head with them, competing with them. How do you approach that subject?
Well, man, I tell you what, now, it took 5 courses to get that one. I know that was tough. No, we have, let me say this about me as a person. I have tremendous respect for every coach in college basketball. I have tremendous respect for our director of athletics. She's a coach. So she comes to me and she tells me something about coaching. I respect her. I can listen to her because she's actually called the time off. She's actually called on the play. She understands what's going on, coming on the court. That being said, I'm the coach at North Carolina State. And my job is to put the best product on the floor. My job is to beat everybody. It doesn't have anything to do with the school down the street. My job is to compete for an ACC championship and also compete for a national championship. And that's all my focus is.
Let's go to the back, and then we'll come back to Corey.
Hey, Coach, Basil John, WWE Warriors. Even though NC State is the next big step, just want to know, how does it feel leaving UNCW? And do you have anything to say to the players from that team?
Oh, absolutely. You know, it was Friday night was the toughest thing that I could ever go through. And it's always that way. You know, and the very unfortunate thing was that there were some reports about me taking the job earlier before I had the opportunity to tell my kids. And it really bothered me because of the fact that, you know, when you recruit guys and you sit in the living room and you recruit the parents and you recruit everybody around them, it's a really tough thing to walk in that room and tell those guys that you're leaving. That being said, you know, I think every kid in the room understood that this was a great opportunity for my family and I. I think they all understand what type of program this is. I think they both, they all accepted it. Toughest thing that I've ever had to do because of the fact that the relationship that you have built. And then the other thing is, you know, obviously, you know, you got to come and talk to some new guys, and you got to lay out your expectations for those guys. And that's so you go from emotional being so down to happy to meet some new guys because you really got a great opportunity. And one of the things I've always told these guys, I told them yesterday, was everybody's got a clean slate. You know, I'm not going to come in and, you know, I'm not thinking about what happened to me the last couple of years. You know, all I'm thinking about is what can we do to get better.
Corey?
Corey's a good person, Journal again. Coach, obviously a lot of the main recruiting at this level. Obviously, you have the experience at Lowell, but how different as a head coach is recruiting going to be here as opposed to it was at UNC, where you build your team based around some of the best transfers in the country as well?
Well, I agree with you and I disagree with you. If you look at the best players at UNCW, leading scorer as a sophomore when he came in as a freshman, CJ Bryce, who's out of Charlotte, North Carolina. If you go back to my track record at Auburn Military Academy, and you go back and you look at David West, and you look at Marvin Spates, and you look at Jordan Crawford, and Joe Alexander, and you look at A.J. Harris and Dez Wells, and you look at all of those guys that we all know that have played in the state. And then you go to Louisville, and you look at the fact that I was able to recruit Terry Rozier and Chatham Journal. I've recruited a lot of really good basketball players. But that being said, recruiting is all about who your head coach is, which is me. And it's all about your resources, obviously, which we have great resources. It's about your ability to get a great education, which we know that that's going to happen because it's an unbelievable institution for that. And it's about the people that you have around and the passionate fan base. When you add all of those together, we've got something special. And, you know, we're not going to just settle for recruits. We're going to try to go out to the best recruits in the country. And, you know, as I told you, I want to recruit and I want to challenge for national championship.
We have time for a few more questions if anybody has them.
That's a great question. We have a big staff. And I don't know if you guys have had the opportunity to watch us, but if you had the opportunity to watch us last year, we played Duke in the NCAA. We're playing Duke, and you take Virginia this year in the NCAA. We don't get many opportunities around the NCAA to play against some bigger schools. Obviously, because we were so successful, we could get none of those schools to come to our place to play. But when you look at the way we play, we're an up-tempo running. We take a lot of threes, we pressure a lot. You look at it, a lot of people say, man, what are they doing on the defensive end? Well, if you really dig deep into our defensive numbers, you realize that we're one of the top teams in the country as far as turning you over. I think the other day we were 69th in the country. We force tempo. We're the only team that I see, and I watch all 30-some games, to be able to make Virginia play fast. When you look at Virginia and how unique Tom Brady is, because you said that, they're a team that prides itself on defense and low possessions. 20 teams played those guys this year, and 20 teams didn't make it to 60 points. When you play, when you see how we play up-tempo, we run, we press. It's going to be an unbelievable system that I think everybody will love. When you talk about the media, I think the media is going to love the coverage. When you talk about the fans, you know, you guys are going to be on your feet. You're going to be cheering. We take a lot of threes. We a lot of dunks. I think the guy that's going to benefit more than anybody is Raleigh. He's going to probably lead the country in dunks next year. It's also recruits love to play. You know, when you talk about our system, it's been very successful. You know, one of the questions will always be, can this system be good at this level? Well, I want you to think about this. At Harvard, we're great. When you talk about UNCW, we're great. We played a very similar system when I was at Louisville in the Big East and two final fours in the national championship. So it'll be fun. I think you'll love it. If you don't, come see me after about a month of us playing, and I'll take you to dinner.
Question for Ben. The process seemed to be really quick once you identified who you wanted. What were the attributes he had that stood out to you and made you want to be friends?
I think that what it boiled down to is shared values. Kevin mentioned, Coach Keatts mentioned that I'm a former coach, and so I have very strong opinions about what it takes to be successful. And the value system is simply online. He loves hard practices. He expects the best out of our players. He's going to maximize whatever abilities they have. And the player development is huge for me. And the fact that he said to me right off the bat, I'll be the one leading player development. I know what that means to players. So the fit academically, the fit competitively in terms of just, he's a grinder. And I say that with a great deal of respect. So academic values, grinding, player development, recruiting, he's just a whole ball of wax. You know, it's rare to find this level of fit in this day and age. And that fit is here. That's why I said when I was talking, I feel like he has the stuff. When you have all of those characteristics, plus the wisdom, to know how to implement your system. Because the players are going to love you as well. No matter what anyone says, players are going to be pushed because they love the result. Winning is fun. So we expect that as well.
Time for one more. Otherwise, we'll go ahead and break into one-on-ones as needed.
Through a little bit of the timeline of the coaching search and speaking with Kevin and just kind of how that unfolded.
Well, we developed the committee initially. Went through all of the paperwork that you would expect us to go through, and then began to sit with the committee and talk about various candidates. Obviously, we're not going to mention names, that's why I noted the committee by name. They were spectacular. Really enjoyed that part of the process because we were working together so well. Well, we met with Kevin on Friday afternoon for several hours. We could still be there talking. It was I mentioned earlier, I called it that alignment of values. It's just there. You can't force some things. And after several hours with him, it became very obvious he was the person. And obviously, we needed to wait to meet until after he was out of the NCAA tournament.
Thank you very much. If anybody needs Dr. Yao, you can come see me. If anybody needs Coach Keatts, or the Director of Communications, Craig Hamill, we'll return to the area up top. You'll need to go to the side corners. Sarah was there the last.